I'm doing this video, so hopefully it reaches people that can help give me some advice. People have been attacking my brain every day for many years, and lately they've been making me so paralyzed by knocking me out and telling me that they're making me too sick to even function each day as a form of torture. They kept telling me they were draining my soul, but I wasn't letting this transformation take place. So they started performing rituals, and every time I try to publish something, they either steal it or they prevent me from collecting royalties, and they attack me, and they attack me, they say, for trying to do my own thing, because they call me slave, and they kept me a slave for many years working for free. And so when I told people, they've been making me a stooge, only that's not good enough for them. I started selling Avon to try to do something, and they kept disconnecting my cell phone every time I would try to talk to the Avon company or a client or to the lady who is my Avon distributor and rep who got me signed up. And then they follow me, and they're just trying to use torture with weapons to kill my soul. They tell me this. And so I finally just broke free, and I said, I can't take this anymore. So this one person that's been in charge of all this says, well, either give us your soul and give us your whole mind and being, or you're going to die. Well, I said, no. So they kept giving me the song Runaway, and then they started, you know, torturing my dad. They gave him a heart attack. They put him in the hospital. They crippled him. And it's because they want control of me. So for all these years, I would do what they said, because if I didn't, they would send cars over to my dad's house. I would see them outside, and he would be suffering. They would be attacking this poor innocent man that doesn't know them, that doesn't know anything about what's going on. And so after the last election, they got more vicious. They seemed to think I had something to do with Putin and Trump getting together, but I think Putin and Trump were already business associates, like all billionaires, because Trump went there for the beauty pageant and everything. But for some reason, they hate me, so they start sending me my husband's kids' pictures and flying my stepson here and said, winner takes all, because I won't let them completely take me over. Well, they started putting ritualistic things in my booth that I got over here at Peddler's Mart to sell Avon. And one day there was a wicker basket over there and a fan. And then that night they tried to burn my dad up. And then they sent me something on the wicker man, which is a man having that done to him. And so the next day, and for a couple weeks, they've been sending me something that says aunt with a heart. So the next day, I have to go to a closing, which was Friday I had to go. And they had started attacking him, giving him chest pains, and they told me they were. They sent me a picture of a heart. And then I knew what was happening to my dad, so I called my ex-federal agent and detective out of state and said, what can I do? And they told me to leave my husband, leave my house to my kids, to my husband's kids, leave, or they would give him a heart attack. And they've been telling me, go to Russia, I have to go to Russia. And I wouldn't until I went over to my dad's last night. He was having those pains again, and they told me they were doing something to his heart. They told me what it was. But before that, after they sent me the aunt picture with the heart, while I was talking to my detective friend on the phone, telling him what they were doing to my dad's sister died, which was the aunt. So show me they're not playing. They really want me in Russia, and they really want me to leave my husband. And they told me they want me to be a slave. So I stayed at my dad's until like 9 a.m. this morning. And then I came home, and when I told them I would leave the country and for them to please get me a visa, if they promised that they wouldn't hurt anybody and they leave everybody else alone, I would go against my desire, because I told them I'd much rather be dead. than leave the people I love. I mean, I have no future. I have no life. How can you do this to someone? How can you numb their brain and paralyze them and tell them give their soul to Satan or die and then do this? How can you do this? But they're doing it. Only after I lay down at 9, I was up all night, they started burning my head, attacking my brain to where I was chilling to the bone. I felt like I was dying. I felt like I was not going to have any brain left. They were just destroying my mind. And now here I am. I finally got the strength to open my eyes and to be able to stop shivering. But my neck and head still burn. And they told me if I lay down, they're going to do something to the back of my neck, spine in my neck. And they do. When they do, I can't feel my hands. I don't think I'm going to be paralyzed. They did that. But the worst thing they did was what they did to my brain. So then I'm not thinking right. I'm shivering. And they want me to feel totally crippled. It's like I'm supposed to go to Russia now. But I'm petrified because I'm scared to leave. I know my life will be over with that love. And I've been with my husband. This is going to be our 25th anniversary in April, and we've been together over 27 years. We built our own home together. We never broke the law. But both of my stepsons joined the special forces, and their brothers did too. And my husband's ex-wife's best friend that lived on our street, they tried to help her win the custody battle when I first met my husband, who, she lived out of state, but she would come and stay at his house. He was Jenna Bush's bodyguard. I mean, what do I do when people have those sort of connections? And they tell me winner takes all, and I was supposed to be a sinner and accept the Antichrist or be a loser. And they've been sending me keys, telling me to join their club and talk to demons. And I've told them I will not talk to demons, but they shattered my brain. They shattered my brain and then told me, well, go in the woods and look for your soul. It's crazy, but I don't have the brain to get into the bullshit. They've been sending me stuff on aliens. My brain, they have destroyed my mind. I don't want to know about anything supernatural. It's crazy. Life is too short. So today, I'm sick. And they're trying to just scare me to death, not only with the stuff they're leaving in my booth for rituals, but the way they're wiping out my mind to make me helpless. And then they send me, like, hunt deer antlers and tell me they're the trophy hunters, and then they keep following me with the deer antlers on their license plates, and they're controlling every aspect of my life, my phones, my home. They tell me they've had cameras in here taking new pictures of me. So today I'm supposed to, I guess, go overseas. So I did follow their wishes, and I did go to Vladimir Putin's Twitter page and say, if you really want me in Russia so bad, if you don't harm anybody I care about and the government here stops hurting people, get me a visa, because I have no choice. I have no choice at all. They said that I'm going to eventually realize they are in me. My body is no longer my own. They do control my mind by remote. And I'm going to let this transformation take place and lose my soul and burn in hell. They said that's the final outcome. And no one in law enforcement will help me. The only person that is trying to not prevent me from going overseas to protect me and trying to get the people in my town that are doing this to leave me alone is ex-federal agent Thomas Martin in California, because he's been the only detective that's been on this case from the very, very first year it started. And he has all the evidence, and Mark Alcock has all the hard drive evidence for over 15 years cloned professionally. And I had a lawyer named Stephen Lowe, and those are the only people that are saving all this. But it won't do any good if the government wants me to go die and leave my loving family, because it's like a satanic offering, some kind of, why would they be putting ritualistic stuff to do with Warner Brothers in my booth? Why would they be hacking my brain to where I'm senseless to try to program my thoughts if this wasn't satanic? They keep saying I'm the chosen one, I'm the Holy Grail. It's insane to pick on a woman's father who's just a hardworking man who was a Vietnam medvac who retired from a factory, who has worked hard his whole life, never had anything for free, never had an easy road. It's just all so evil and heartless. And it's sick to put my family's names, real names, in John Saul's book, Black Creek Crossing, and to use my ideas and films and books and then put my face in Disney animation and say that this is all predestined, which it's not in my heart. And so I know it's not. I know they're crazy. I know what's in my heart. And none of these people are there. They scare me. I don't want anyone else in my heart but my family, my husband. But they seem to think this, and it's like some crazy play that they're trying to act out that has no realism to me whatsoever. I can never get close to any of their people. I said to my husband today when they were attacking me, I said, oh God, I just wish I could die in your arms. Please let me die in your arms. It's a nightmare to be with a bunch of strangers. It's so horrible to be tortured for 15 years and lose your mind. But the ultimate evil is just not to be able to die with someone you love. Go off and be murdered by some strangers because they're so freaking evil. How would they like to have someone pull them away from their partner? How would they like to be forced to leave their home that they put their heart and soul in, that gave them the inspiration to write the things that made them famous? Several films and books even had sequels. How would they, my home was my inspiration. My husband was my love that made me feel so grounded and solid and whole, that made me see life beautiful. How can they get me away from the only thing that will make me creative and try to put me in darkness, which kills me? Their evil is making me die. I get sick from evil. They're trying to put that thing in me. I got sick. That's killing me. And now it's insane. They want to conduct all these experiments. My heart and soul is not in that. My heart and soul is here. And I'm dying. And all that will happen is if they don't murder me, I'll die in their company. Because I despise evil and it makes my anatomy sick. It's killing my soul. It's not who Sherry is. It's not who Sherry ever was. And I know I've been dying for a very long time every time they conduct these experiments. They're breaking my will by destroying my brain, by causing terror every single day. And this evil doesn't accomplish anything. It only hurts them. It only destroys their soul. It only makes God damn and condemn them. God won't condemn me because I'm broken, because I resist this, because he knows that my soul is pure. So they're going to try everything they can to tarnish it.